None of us dreamt that in 24 hours we'd have over a million downloads.
It has given me some hope that things will be improved.
It was March 2020. COVID has started hitting around Europe, and to be honest, at that point we didn't realize what was happening.
There was a 5-day doubling period, and whenever you see a doubling period in a virus, that is really a sign of concern.
So before the pandemic, I was working at ZOE as an engineer looking at the Predict 2 study, which was looking at how individual responses to foods can vary so much between person to person. When the pandemic hit, we found that we could take all of those great skills and pivot towards the COVID problem.
The main reason I'm doing it is I hope I'm helping to contribute to the studies of COVID, although thank goodness I haven't suffered anything personally myself.
ZOE was founded with this idea that if you get a large number of people to collect data at home and then use machine learning, you can really understand things that nobody's been able to do before.
Myself and my wife have been using the ZOE symptom tracker app since the very beginning, last year. Because we wanted to be part of science.
Tim had a relationship with ZOE already. ZOE has an ability to put our ideas into a format that can then be disseminated across the nation really very rapidly and is really easy for people to do.
Because at the end of the day, what we're trying to do is transform people's health, trying to do something that really matters. And right now, it seems like fighting COVID is the most important thing that we can do.
I think it's something that can make a real difference to the COVID-19 pandemic. If everyone was contributing, I think we'd have had it cracked a lot sooner.
So when Professor Tim Spector came to the team at ZOE, he challenged us with how could we build an app that would make it possible to allow the public to give data to contribute to the science behind understanding how the pandemic was spreading in the UK.
We had this very, very clear mission statement, which is COVID is impacting us now. You know, in the UK, we're entering lockdown. We don't have good visibility on what is happening, so we need an app now.
And 5 days later, the amazing team at ZOE had turned it around and we had an app that was launched on the 24th of March.
We very, very rapidly had some kind of viral effect that was absolutely incredible.
None of us dreamt that in 24 hours we'd have over a million downloads, and all the servers that ZOE was using crashed. So we had a time when downloading was going viral.
And we knew at that scale, the data that we collected could be really useful to understand how the pandemic was spreading through the population.
It's been really important to me because it's given me a chance to see what's happening in the world.
Thanks to the millions of users and the daily logs in the app, we are able to estimate incidence and prevalence at the UK level and go down to the local region in order to tell you about the number of cases in your area.
One of the really exciting moments that came really in the first week was that we could see that in the individuals that had reported they had a positive test, we could see very clear symptom structure that was different from people who had a negative test.
A practical example is the paper around anosmia, which led to it being one of the core symptoms on the government list in order to be able to prevent, you know, getting COVID.
This was done at 100 times the speed you'd do a traditional research project at a fraction of the cost.
We are essentially pioneering a new type of science in fighting COVID with the way that we are. And that's by bringing together the public to help scientists with these discoveries that might not otherwise happen.
I think what we're doing is making people feel like they have some sort of way to contribute. I think by logging on a daily basis, you feel like you're actually actively helping.
I've recommended it to loads of friends, one of whom reported non-standard symptoms, not the three that the government seems to recognise for COVID, and as a result got through the ZOE app a COVID test which proved positive, and as a result he and his family isolated and stopped the spread.
It's made a real difference to me and my family as well. It's made us consider our health much more closely.
So the app's still really important in understanding changes as we go forward. There's a number of new challenges. One is the vaccines. How effective are they? That's something we're already looking at.
We are not necessarily out of the woods when it comes to COVID. We hear often about new variants appearing from time to time. With that in mind, I think it's very important for our contributors to keep logging, and in doing so help us to create this early warning system.
There's been completely new research that has been done and has helped practically save people's lives.
Everything that they've seen that comes out, whether it's, you know, new understanding of the science of COVID, the risks or whether it's about understanding the level of cases in different areas, is entirely down to each individual actually just using that app each day, filling in that information and sharing it. And so I think it's been an extraordinary community effort.
Together, we're an amazing team that hopefully we can continue working for the next year until we've really got rid of this virus properly. So thank you, stay safe, and keep logging.